Alright, this is CPU Kid, and this is part 2 of the PlayStation 3 review. And this, I'm going to be talking about the hardware, so just like an overall look of the PS3. So, to get started, since this is the 40 gig model, this is not chrome, it's just like a silver. So it's not reflective, but it's just, as that the way I look at it, it's less to get fingerprints on, so I kind of like just having it being silver. So, and then this right here is the disk drive. It's obviously a Blu-ray drive, DVD, CD. And if this were the 60 or 80 gig model, I'd be able to play PS2 games, but I have a PS2, so it doesn't. I don't really care. I'll show you in the next video when I have it powered on, but you just kind of put the disc in, it takes in itself, which is really nice. So your disc won't get scratched as easy. These are touch sensitive, so like if you just like rub your finger, it'll pop out, and over here, it'll turn on, or if you hold it in, it'll go into standby. And this, if you have the PS3 tilted up like this, the PlayStation icon tilts, so you'd be looking at it like that, and it'd be right. And it says, let me see if I can, it says Sony over here. So now if you turn it this way, this right here, you can't see it that well probably, but it's the hard drive bay. And so, yes, Sony lets you put another hard drive in here. It just takes a standard laptop hard drive. So I'll show you how you take it off. There's like a little insert right here. You just kind of get a knife or something, and you just pop it out. And then you take out this blue screw, and then how it comes out. So I think it can hold. I'm not sure the exact size it holds. Like I said, this is a 40 gig, but some places say it can take up to 250 gigs. And some other places say it takes 750. Every place I check is different. So, but like I said, it's just a standard laptop hard drive. So there's no special hard drive like the 360, which is really nice. There's no special hard drive that you need. So, and once you swap out your hard drive, you just put this back on. That's it. Now rotating this way is the back of the PlayStation 3. And you can see all the different ports here. Let's see if I can... Alright, so this is just for AV cables, like the RGB cables, the red, white, and yellow cables. This is digital out, this is HDMI, high definition, this is for Ethernet. I use wireless, so I don't use this. And then here's a switch to go, this is on standby, this is off, and that's where the power adapter goes. Which is really nice about this is the brick is built in. So there's no huge brick like there is on the 360, which is awesome. And then over here is just a very big fan grill. And then from left to right, Blu-ray disc, DVD-ROM, compact disc, Dolby True HD, Dolby Digital, DTS, Bluetooth, HDMI. And then I'll show you the top of the PS3 real quick. You see it's very shiny. Hello. PlayStation 3, it's like a Spider-Man font. It's really nice. The one thing I don't like about the PS3 is that since it's black, you can see that it takes fingerprints really easily. And you can just get like a Kleenex or whatever, and they come off pretty easy, but it also shows dust really easy. But I was gonna get a ceramic white one, but I couldn't find one cheap, and it was, you have to import it, and that would cost money, which I don't have. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the hard drive or the hardware. If this was a 60 gig, you'd have some more features. One of them is this would flip up, and there's some card readers. There's like SD, compact flash, it's in some order, and then memory stick pro. So, yep, that's it for the hardware, and I'll be back for the next review.